Hey there. So for the third week in a row, we have an accolades video. And this time it's both Raleigh, North Carolina, and our next door neighbor of Durham that have respectively been named the number 2 and number 4 hottest housing markets in the US, according to US News and World Report. So buckle up because we're about to uncover what makes Raleigh Durham shine. But first, if you're new here, my name is Matt Martin, and I'm a Raleigh-based realtor. I've helped tons of clients relocate to the Triangle region, and if you're looking to do the same, I'd love to help you too. And if you want to see more videos like this, please be sure to like, comment, and subscribe right down below. So I promise to get back to beautiful neighborhood tours and footage soon, but as that Noah Kahan song goes, we're in the middle of stick season right now, so it's not the best time to show y'all all the greenery that makes Raleigh so beautiful. So let's instead talk about what all the experts are saying about why it's so great to live here and what exactly landed Raleigh the prestigious number 2 spot and Durham the number 4 spot on the list of hottest housing markets. Let's break it down. First off, to come up with the list of hottest real estate markets in the country, US News and World Report looked at 57 metros across the US and then broke each down into 3 categories: demand, supply, and financial. Let's kick things off with demand. Of course, a hot market is going to have crazy high demand, and that's definitely true here in the Raleigh-Durham area. In fact, with about 80 people moving to the Triangle region every day, demand is on fire. Many people are moving here for jobs, so the report looked at new job creation versus housing permits issued to see if production is keeping up with demand. On this metric, Raleigh did better than the national average. But beyond new people moving into the area, demand is defined by how many people want and are able to buy or rent in the market. So the want part is determined by consumer sentiment, which has grown nearly 20% over the past year. This is partly driven by the recent softening in rates, but I also believe it's due to many buyers in the market coming to terms with the fact that rates will not be going back down to 3 or 4%. So that's the want to buy measurement. On the able to buy side, the report looked at unemployment, which sits around 2.9% in Raleigh versus 3.8% nationally. So we have more of our population employed and able to buy, which is driving demand. And now Boomer is making a guest appearance in the background. So if you partner all those factors with our relatively low median home price of about $450,000, you can see why the Raleigh-Durham market is so hot from a demand perspective. On the supply side of things, we look at how much inventory there is for all the demand and how willing and able developers are to build more. And unfortunately, the supply metrics are where Raleigh-Durham and really the whole country are struggling. That's because of high construction costs, which have skyrocketed nearly 40% since 2019 due to COVID demand, and they just haven't found their way back down. This has also led to lower builder confidence. But on the positive side, the absorption rate has gone up to 2.4 months, which means that if no new properties were listed on the market, it would take about 2.4 months for the current supply to be bought up. So why is that a good thing? Well, during the COVID craze, absorption rates were down to below 1 month, which meant that inventory was flying off the shelves and buyers had very little time to make any decisions. And while a 2.4 month supply still very strongly indicates a seller's market, it at least means that there is more inventory in the market for buyers to absorb, giving them a little more time to make decisions and making them more willing to dip their toes back in. And if you're not in the market to buy, the report also looked at rental vacancy rates, which sit around 7% for Raleigh. This number was down in the 2 to 3% range just a couple of years ago, but a huge investment in new apartment construction has made renting more accessible to many. And finally, the report looked at a variety of financial factors that drive buyers and renters' activity in the market. And this is where Raleigh-Durham really stood out. These metrics look at a consumer's ability to afford whatever they're buying or renting based on home prices, income, and rates. On average in Raleigh-Durham, homeowners are spending about 25% of their income on their mortgage compared to a national average of about 35%. So For a family making $100,000, that's about $10,000 per year less. On the apartment side, renters in Raleigh Durham are shelling out about 30% of their income versus 36% nationwide. And while late payments and foreclosures are incredibly rare nationwide at less than 1%, Raleigh Durham is still performing better. This should come as no surprise given the surge in Raleigh Durham's economy, primarily driven by jobs in well-paying sectors like tech and pharma, paired with our still relatively low median home prices. So let's recap. Raleigh, North Carolina and Durham, North Carolina were just respectively named the number 2 and number 4 hottest real estate markets in the country. This was driven by a high demand due to our low unemployment, rising consumer confidence, and about 80 people moving to the Triangle region every day. It was also driven by our relative affordability, especially as compared to the region's median income, which makes buying and renting more accessible to our residents. And while construction costs have spiked and builders' confidence has dropped, Raleigh is still doing better than the nation at large, with construction permits keeping up with new employment opportunities. And we're seeing more inventory on the market for buyers to choose from. So there you have it, folks. Are you surprised by the rankings? Let me know in the comments below. And if you're ready to come see for yourself what makes Raleigh and Durham such hot real estate markets, I'd love to hear from you. You can find all my contact information below.